Oh my God, I'm so dumb. Damn it. Okay, deal with it. You're gonna get so tilted. It's all about the text effect, okay? Not what it says. I love you. What is going on, guys? It's your boy Seso here. There's a video here today bringing you guys a Photoshop tutorial to create your own. I guess we can say improving the illustrated 3D tutorial, if you guys remember that tutorial. But we're basically gonna be improving your banner designs, period, with just one thing alone, and that's just focusing on the text, right? So let me just show you guys, right? So this is the word improve. I like told myself I spoke this wrong 5 times, but I didn't, right? Okay, anyway, I don't know why it doesn't even look right. Anyway, right? So let me just show you guys, right? Let's just see. We're gonna like zoom out just a little bit right there, and we're gonna show you guys without the sort of illustrated text right here. Here it is, and I can say that a lot of you guys personally know shots fired, anything like that, but of course I've done at least 1,000, what are we at, like 1,600 portfolio reviews on the stream. So I know a lot of you guys do text like this, and I was wondering to myself, like, maybe I just gotta show them again. Maybe I just gotta show them even better this time, so you can see the big difference in quality, I guess you would say, when you look at the text itself being the sort of, not the center of the attention, but I guess just giving the text a little bit of light, I guess you would say, right? A little bit of improvement. So here it is right here. If you want to zoom in really quickly, you can see a few things we did, like something like this right here. We have a little pattern in the background as well. Very nice gradients. And as well, guys, in the description down below for you guys is going to be all the layer styles that I use. All the little style, like little, what do you call them? These things. All the layer style styles. So if you guys want to go ahead and choose those and want to download those, you can get the exact settings I'm using in today's video, because I'm just going to be using the layer styles in today's video, just so we can kind of speed things up as well as just kind of get all the information out there as well. So if you guys want to see the other one we did around, I believe it was January, and it's of course in, you know, January, February, March, I had to say that out loud, March to I guess you can say, like, you know, the two month difference, right? And dude, it's fucking way better. So honestly, if you think about it, like, you can just see the improvement alone, and just like me kind of working around with 3D illustrated text and whatnot inside Cinema 4D, and it looks good, so I'm really happy about it. I'm going to show you guys exactly how I'm going to do it. I'm going to close this down here, we don't need that there, and yeah, hopefully you guys enjoy. 200 likes on the video equals a secret down below, which most likely be the PSD of the video here today. But as I said before as well, the layer styles in the description are ready for you guys to go ahead and download. So I'm going to get this thing going, and let's get this thing going. Let's go. All right, homies, let's go and get this thing going right here, right now. So the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and use the tutorial group, and that's gonna be the one that kind of has that plain little text to it, and we're gonna fix that one up right here, right now, right? So first things first, of course, I'm gonna let you guys know that if we use it a text, of course, and kind of like relate it to the game itself, no matter what, this entire style can be used in different, like, aspect of different games. Right now it's very cartoony, Fortnite-y, but if you use different materials, different color schemes, it will look exactly the way you kind of want it to have to the certain game that you're using it for. So one thing's for certain, if you guys are gonna be using text, by the way, this font is called Burbank. It's basically the Fortnite font. I don't think it's the original font, however, if you get, like, if you Google Fortnite Finder, you're probably gonna find this as the closest one, and it works perfectly fine. Improve, just like so. Now, if I press Control T, it brings the free transform. Everyone knows that, right? When you right click, you can have the option to scale, rotate, skew, if you guys want to kind of move it around in different ways. And right now, perspective is unchecked because you have to rasterize a layer, the text layer afterwards to actually get this thing unlocked. So we're gonna do that in a little bit. However, if you guys don't know about warps and whatnot, I believe warps are really, really cool, and they should be used a lot more than you guys think. So if you guys look up top left, once you guys actually select on the warp table, you can use arc, which what I use in my tutorial here today, in my example. So something like this, or you can use something like bulge is pretty cool, right? It just different little aspects, these little simple little things you can do to your text kind of like makes it just so much better, so much more unique, so much like just different, right? And you guys want to get that different look to when you guys do your own banner design and stuff like that, because I don't know who wants to be the same all the time, right? So you can do a lot of different things. This is flag here, but we're going to be using in our tutorial here today, we're just going to be using a nice little arc here, and then just dragging this little point down, and all the other ones in here as well. If you have any little point here, it'll actually, you just move it a little bit up or down. I believe not left or right, unless it actually has that enable if it's like left or right, but you can use any different thing. Like, that looks pretty cool as well, actually. Right, so this, it's a lot you can do. Honestly, I would honestly just explore this a little bit if you guys have no clue about this or not, if you don't use it or not, but it's definitely something I'm gonna be using a lot more. I'm gonna give myself a nice little simple arc here, And like I said before, I'm gonna be using perspective, but I won't be able to actually do it unless I unlock it and give it a rasterize layer. So if I go ahead here, right click on my text and use rasterize type, I can then control T on my keyboard, bring up the perspective tool, and give myself a nice little perspective that's just a little bit different. So what I did is kind of like move my little bottom right key to just more of the right, moving my mouse more to the right, and then over here, top left, I just moved it up to kind of give myself that little tilt, which looks pretty cool. So I'm gonna go ahead and just check this in right here. And I'm gonna say that it's a pretty good start to our little text here. And yeah, there we go. So it's a little closer to this. Oops, where is improve? Right here, right? It's a little more closer to this. As you can see, that's how I got that nice little angle. It's a little bit different and it's very cool. So once I have this, we're all good to start this thing off. So I gave you guys, of course, these styles in the description down below. Now I'm gonna give it kind of like one very quick rundown, because realistically the styles themselves are just sort of like repeated, but of course tuned differently for things that have to like have different shadows or to give it more, I guess, pull out different like highlights that you might have put behind it or in front of it. So stuff like that. But the first style I'm gonna be using is, I like put it in order, by the way, so you don't have to worry about it. So this is style number two, excuse me. So what I have on here is bevel and emboss, right? What I went ahead are emboss. I don't know how to say it ever, but whatever. Bevel and emboss. For my highlights, of course, I use white. And then for my shadows, I did use a certain color. I use a darker color of the color that you selected for your highlighted, or excuse me, your font or text color, right? So of course I have yellow. So I'm gonna be using myself, and I'm gonna be using, excuse me, a nicer sort of like mustardy yellow. So that way it is not black. It doesn't look awkward. It doesn't look weird. It doesn't look, cause right now I wanna make sure I keep that cartoony feel. Most cartoony feels, they kind of have that really cool sort of certain colors that you're gonna be using in sort of like a continuous, you know, concept, or excuse me, a continuous color scheme. There we go. I was looking for that word. For some reason, it completely blanked me. But as you can see, it looks really, really cool. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. So at first, you probably won't be able to see the highlights that are up here in the top right, or excuse me, the top sides of the actual fonts. But there are these little white highlights here, which look a lot better when actually put on sort of like a backing, right? So if I just uncheck this really quickly again, you can see these little white highlights you can see right here are being able to be seen a lot better, because we have this very nice dark purple in the background here. And of course, these little, harder yellow mustardy spots that I had before, you'll be able to see those as well. And so you kind of feel it and like build it, and you can see like it has a layer to it, right? So that's one thing. And of course I have a stroke here. It's kind of like a little way of actually applying like a little bit of a sharpen almost, because it kind of defines each of the edges of the actual font itself, or the text itself. And of course an inner glow here. All these different colors, gonna be seeing orange. If you're using a blue for your text, make sure you guys change these colors to a corresponding color. If you guys want to, you can even stay here, and then like if you're using blue, like stay around here, because you can see it does change the overall aspect, the overall tone, or the overall, I guess you could say, cohesiveness of the text. You can see right here, it looks like right now it looks nice and yellow, or you know, orange and whatnot. But if I change the blue, it kind of changes. It looks kind of like dulled out, mustard out, and kind of how do you say, just what's the word I'm looking for? It looks muted, dried. Oh God, please someone comment it down below if I don't say it. Oh God. Okay, one more second. Just give me one more second. Nope, I forgot. All right, someone at least comment it down, please. Okay, so yeah, that's one thing right here. So that's kind of like our first little step. What we're doing is we're repeating this process about four times. We're gonna do another duplicate for this backing of the actual improved word. We can do that right now. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna press Control J on our keyboard, just like so. And let's go ahead and just make this one red. No, let's just make this orange and whatnot, so you know that this is the first one. And this one right here does not need to be here anymore. We're gonna go ahead and just clear these layer styles here. Just like so, double click on this. Now, if there's one thing you don't have selected, if you guys don't know already, if you don't have the show all options, sometimes when you select a style in Photoshop, it actually just gives you guys only the things that are actually in the style itself that you did previously. So that way, if you need to do it over again, you kind of know what you're gonna be using. However, if you guys don't know already, just on effects, you can show all effects once again, so you don't have to, you never lost them, okay? So also one thing, make sure you guys have preview selected. Sometimes, for me, I don't know what has been going on recently, but sometimes preview is unselected for me, so make sure you guys show preview. That way when you do things like this right here, right, you can start to see them. So what I'm gonna do is drop shadow, lower my size all the way down to zero. We're gonna put this to normal and bring that all the way up to the opacity, and we're gonna go ahead and just sort of get a nice little, I believe almost 15 looks pretty dang good to me. That does look pretty good, not even gonna lie. I kind of like that. Okay, so what I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna quickly just kind of find a better color. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select on the kind of mustardy orange a little bit. around here, just like so that little mustardy orange, kind of like figure out just a little bit more on my little actual hue bar here. Going up or down, I kind of figure out if it looks a little bit better. And I'm gonna say right about here looks pretty dang good. So press OK again. Now it doesn't need to be that far out. We can see, I can just check again for my other one. It was a little less, just like literally the tiniest bit less. So I'm gonna go ahead and say like 13 or so. And press OK. So what we're kind of doing here is making our text look 3D, right? You guys already know my tutorial from last or 2 months ago. You guys kind of like know what's going to be happening here in a second. We're going to have to make sure that this kind of looks nice and just sort of even and doesn't have like any weird things like this, right? Or it looks kind of off. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to, like, of course, make a new layer. And what we're going to do is we're going to take our pen tool here. And anywhere you see it kind of looks off, maybe just click over here and like kind of make sure you kind of fill it out, right? So just like so, I'm gonna fill this right there. I'm gonna go ahead and say, this is okay for tutorial purposes. I'm gonna leave that one, but this for sure needs to be fixed, right? Just like so, connected then. That's pretty good. Up here, usually you gotta fix these kind of things right here. You see these little empty spaces? I would definitely fix it. All this kind of stuff here is, of course, if you wanna have quality in your text, in your banner designs, this is what designing is all about. Really, not just no more copy and pasting. Also, did I spit when I said design? That's weird. No, not just copy and pasting sometimes. Sometimes in the word design, you're gonna have to design something. So make sure you guys give it that attention that it feels like it needs, of course. If someone's paying you some money for stuff, show them the quality. That way you can actually justify how much you might charge or how little you might charge and how much you wanna start charging, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and say that this is pretty okay. A little, just for your little tweaks right now. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna press right click, fill path on a new layer right here, as I already have, fill path, drop down, use color. And I'm gonna select the color of the drop shadow that we use currently. Press okay again. And I believe we got the right color. Oh, however, I have a color balance on over here. So I'm gonna change that. And we're gonna get rid of this brightness and contrast for a second. That way I can get the actual color for 1 second, just like so. There we go. So now I'll turn on this back on. So if you guys do have color schemes on, or excuse me, color corrections on, and you choose a color, it's gonna choose a color with the color scheme, so the color correction applying. So make sure you guys do that. Okay, let's see. Okay, now this is all done. This is our drop shadow layers right here. We're just gonna basically combine these two layers together, just like so. This will also get rid of the text effect that we already had on it, the drop shadow. So if I ever want to, I can apply yet again another drop shadow. However, I don't want that. That way I can actually apply the layer styles that I actually use in the actual styles right here. And it was these right here. So of course I only use highlights for this. That way we can kind of highlight the fact that it kind of looks 3D, right? So when I did this before, I did do it with like a brush itself, and I kind of messed up the whole, I guess you can say, lighting of it, because right now, if you guys don't know Photoshop's technology, of course, it kind of has, and it kind of makes sure that all the little effects, everything is very even and very accurate, right? And of course, doing it yourself is a lot funner, a lot cooler, whatever. Funner, is that a word? It doesn't work sometimes, right? So you kind of get lost, you kind of figure out that you're missing spots, but if you do it with a layer style, it looks pretty damn good. Like, I can't even lie, just that alone looks really good. And you can make, of course, the 3D sort of depth look a lot bigger if you were to go ahead in the previous step and make your drop shadow very, very, like, just more wider. But that also leaves different areas for things to kind of mess up, so that's when you have to do more fixes and stuff like this. But this looks pretty good so far. And okay, I'm excited. So the next thing is, I believe, is the outline purple, right? So right here, I'm talking about this right here, the inside purple, not the outline purple. This is the inside purple right here first. So the way we're gonna do that is, of course, we're gonna be using the pen tool once again, and also we're gonna be using a sort of stroke to kind of give ourselves a, I guess you'd say, previewed outline, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna go ahead and we're just gonna use this one right here. It's fine. We're just gonna go ahead and call this number 2. We're gonna make this, just make it a different color, like yellow, right? That's second layer. And this is our third layer here. I'm gonna rake really quickly, just clear this layer style, just like so. And I'm gonna go ahead and just open this up, show all, please, and then use stroke. And we're gonna go ahead and just make this stroke, excuse me, position on the outside. And we're gonna make this stroke pretty, let's just say right about here for now, about 38. Let's just see if it's kind of accurate. It's a little bit too much compared to my other one. I'm trying to get it as close as possible for you guys, so that way you can guys get a very, very clear, I guess you'd say, a representation of what I had before. I'll say 21 is pretty good. So once you've done this, this is where you have the pen tool, of course. I'm gonna speed this up right when I get like halfway, because we're gonna have to do this another time. I'm gonna speed it up fully. But just so you guys know, I'm gonna be doing this right here with a pen tool, new layer, pressing P on my keyboard to bring this thing up. Now, The reason why we're doing this pen tooling it over again is because right now, as you can see, these are sort of rounded edges, right? This is not Illustrator where you can kind of get that really nice look to it where it's always sharp and whatnot, or rounded if you guys choose to have it so. Basically, I'm gonna just be starting here, giving it all this sort of nice cuts. You can see this little dip here, make sure that's nice and straight. You see this little rounded edges here. I'm gonna make sure I kind of make sure that this is no longer rounded, because of course, if the font itself was rounded, then this would be like make a lot more sense, but it does not make any sense at all. And the fact that if you guys leave it like this, it just shows like not negligence, but it's just, it ruins the concept alone. If you guys were to do this and kind of leave this like this, it shows laziness in a way, and it's very, just don't do it, please. Let's see. Let's just go ahead and do this like this. Let's just go ahead and give ourselves a nice little rounded. U, is that an O? That's an O. Right, just like so. And I'm gonna have to speed up the rest really quickly, just so you guys can just, like, I kind of explain all the other stuff. So let's just finish that really quick and get to the other parts. All right, now this is all done. I'm gonna go ahead now. So what I can do is I can just kind of get rid of this whole entire little, not this, oops, excuse me. This entire layer right here, and I'm just gonna delete that just like so. That way I have my outline that's very clean, way more better, and just looks way more professional and thought out and actually, yeah, I designed, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and do on a new layer is I'm gonna use a purple, and hopefully I can find the same purple as before. What I might have to do is, let's just go ahead and like uncheck this, double click this, color, overlay, purple, press that just like so. And now I kind of have that nice purple, right? And it looks a little bit too more, like it looks too blue. I'm gonna have to just give it that purplish look just like so. Press okay. And if you ever use color overlays and using like a layer style pack or layer styles period, that kind of give you guys the actual accurate layer styles. Make sure you guys rasterize the layer type, just kind of get rid of that entire layer completely and kind of believe like it wasn't ever there in the first place, right? So now that I have this, I can go ahead and just give you guys this layer style, which of course is the second one here. Excuse me, the third one here, and this is gonna have it, give it like a nice darker tone to it, right? It also has a little bit of a gradient overlay, kind of gives you guys the outlook that, of course, they have a darker sort of bottom for our sort of 3D text that we just did, right? So it kind of course, highlights that. And then again, giving these little inner shadows here, it might be a little too dark for some of you guys. However, I did like it being that little bit of a darkness here, or even this little blue right here. It might be a little bit too blue for you guys on the bevel and emboss. What you can do is, if you have a very dark, I have a very dark purple right now, right? So if I can just move this up a little bit, you can see it kind of changes the color scheme just a little bit too much. I'm gonna go ahead and just say, maybe around there is even a little more better for you guys if you guys don't want it super, super dark. But for me, I did like it being that dark. So I'm gonna say that is pretty dang good. So of course, next up is gonna be the actual other like outing piece of it. That's kind of like a little white kind of coating of this actual purple, because what that does is kind of like tones your eyes. If you guys don't know already, if I were to go ahead and just make this, right, completely white, you can see it kind of like messes with your eyes a little bit. It kind of gives things, maybe it looks darker, maybe it looks even more less color, whatever. It might look less vibrant or less darker to you. Right now for me, it kind of makes it look a little bit, I guess you would say a little less darker for me. It'll look a little less contrast, right? So what that's gonna be doing here is if I put a white on the outside of this, it's gonna make all of our colors kind of like almost be impacted by that and kind of like give it like a nice, I guess to say vibrance on the inside, because of course you have purple on the outside as well. So what I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna go ahead and just make a new layer. I'm gonna copy this layer, excuse me, Control J on our keyboard. And we're gonna use a green for this. This is our third layer here. I'm gonna go ahead and of course clear this layer style. And I'm gonna do a nice stroke once again. So show all. Stroke, make sure it's on the outside, make it a little bit bigger, and this is going to be white, right? So you can just make that white immediately. And we're going to give ourselves a pretty okay thickness. I'll say about 10 is pretty accurate and pretty okay. So of course, once again, you have to go back into the pen tool and then get this rounded edges out of the way. So I'm going to do that right now again, make a new layer, and I'll see you guys in a quick second as I go ahead and just pen tool this all over again. Okay, let's do it. Okay, this is all done now. What I'm gonna do is, of course, delete this layer here. And just like so, the reason why I'm dragging it inside, if I press delete my keyboard, it's gonna firstly target the path, as you can see right here. If I press delete my keyboard, it'll target the path first. That's why I'm kind of deleting it with the little drag and drop here. That way I don't delete the path on accident. So on our new layer, all I can do now is right click, fill the path in, and we can just use a nice solid white, just like so. And then, of course, right click, delete the path. And as you can see, that white coating really, really does do something. And it kind of gives that purple. Of course, you can now see the better highlights here. You can start to see stuff like right here. Kind of looks like little lumps and whatnot. If you really can't tell what that really is, if you guys don't have that little outer coating here. And that looks very accurate, very nice, professional, clean, and whatnot. And so, of course, lastly, we're gonna firstly, let's also kind of add these little layer styles to this one. And what for this one is, well, I believe it's only a bevel animal, so you can't really tell what it is quite yet until you have a purple there. But as you can see, let's just go ahead and try to see if we can see it just a little bit. Also, I believe this has to be a little bit lesser. I'm going to take my lightness and not make it completely white, but make it just maybe like, yeah, it's going to have to be like more of a gray. So you can see what's happening here. What I did was I pressed Control U on my keyboard. So right now it's completely white. This layer is completely white. You guys saw me when I filled it in. I chose simple, like a plain, clean white, right? But what I'm going to have to do is I'm make it a little bit more lesser. So I'm going to make it, of course, kind of more gray, right? So I pressed Control U on my keyboard. And then I just took my lightness and just dragged this down a little bit until we get this little effect here. Because that's what I definitely want to have, right? Press OK. And now you can start to see that little white little outline coating look a bit better and kind of give that bezel and embose that we kind of want it to have. So lastly will be this little piece right here, right? This little purple outline right here. So once again, actually that's not the last one. That's the second to last one. Unfortunate. I have to do this entire thing. Yeah, again. So what's going to happen here is you guys know the drill. We're going to go ahead and copy. And we're drag this down. We're gonna make this this is number 4 here. So this is right here. Right click, clear this layer style. Double click on this for show all. And then outside, let's just give it that purple outline that we need. Let's just make it 10 again, just like so. Press OK. Yeah, yeah. Okay, nice. Now that we have this done, I can then go ahead, uncheck this, delete this one, excuse me. Then on my new layer here, right click, fill this path in, and we're gonna drop down, use a color, and we're gonna select this purple right here, just like so. And that's pretty good. So I was kind of thinking to myself that, you know, this is kind of repetitive, right? You're gonna have to do a lot of pen tooling of the same exact things over again. Now, essentially you can use Illustrator for this, maybe if you guys kind of like plan out the layers themselves, or if you really want to, if you want to keep the little rounded edges, I mean, that's not bad, but personally, I just think designing it over and over again, it kind of really does show, kind of the sharpness itself just looks way, way better, I think, when it comes to rounded edges. I don't know, it can be like my personal preference, but I just want to get that out there. So you don't have to always do it, but I think you should always do it, you know what I mean? So, styles right here, we're going to be using this right here. Now, this right here looks really, 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 really good. Let's go ahead and make sure I'm using the right one. Am I using the right one? And I am using the right one because this one is the other one. Okay. Yeah, because this one is the outside one. So this is right here. Okay, so I believe we actually use the same one for the actual white outline here, right? As you can see, what kind of happens when you use the purple, the same exact one. Of course, purple is a darker color. White is, you know, a very, of course, vibrant color. I guess you would say shade. But as you can see, it just makes it look so dang good. Of course, this is the same exact thing as the other one. So I already showed you guys this, of course. So it's white on white, and this one is vivid light. Is the reason for vivid light is I wanted to use more of a softer white, but I didn't want to use a gray because the gray kind of like dulled out the purple way too much. So what I did was I used vivid light for a white here. It kind of just kind of made it a more of a soft light, the way you'd want soft light to work, rather than actually having it look a little bit dulled out or kind of, what is the word that I was looking for? Muted is a word. Okay, I got you. Press OK again. And so yeah, you can see that we're not done quite yet. There's only one more thing to do. Bless. But yeah, this is pretty good. It looks pretty freaking fantastic right now. So, oh, I kind of messed up the pen tooling here, but I gotta fix this. This just looks awkward. Okay, there we go. God, there we go. Sweet. So, perfect. Now that I have this all done here, one more duplicate, just like so. We're gonna make this the violet here. This is number 6, right? So I'm gonna go ahead and just clear this layer style, just like so. And we're just gonna simply use our movement, of course, movement tool here, just like simple little V on your keyboard. And we're just gonna drag this and move this over just like this. What I could also do is we can also just go ahead and kind of like use a drop shadow as well. If I want to, if I cleared this layer style, I forgot what I did. I don't know if I moved it or use a drop shadow. I'm gonna use a drop shadow first because I feel like it's kind of the same exact thing. Go ahead, uncheck global light, change my angle, and then kind of move this down just like so. And I'm gonna say that looks pretty dang good. Right about there almost. Maybe mess around with this angle a little more. Is that pretty good? Is that pretty accurate? I think it's pretty accurate to what I had. It's a little less on this one, just like so. Drop shadow, just a little more less. I would say like maybe around here and then kind of maybe fix that a little bit again. Right? Does that look pretty okay? Now, I'm also confused if I did also move it, like I said. I think I also moved it. I have no clue. It's doing the same exact thing, though, so I'm just going to use the drop shadow. Anyway, okay, so I'm going to say that's pretty good right there. What I'm going to have to, of course, do is I'm going to go ahead and, like, fix this a little bit. I want to get this kind of perfect, so give me 1 second. I'm going to, like, speed this up just a little bit. I need to make sure it's a little bit more perfect than I have it. All right, so this is the closest I can get to it. The reason why I was kind of having a little bit of trouble is because the first thing we did was use perspective and stuff like that. So my perspective is a little bit different. So my eyes and M is kind of giving me a little empty space here. But I'm gonna show you guys exactly how I'm gonna personally fix it. So if you do run into the same problem, it's not all, you know, it's all lost and whatnot. However, I wanted to get it as close as possible that I was of course the example, because every time I look at the comments sometimes, you guys are like, yo, it's like one of me's did it. You know, when I say like one of me's, I mean like one of you guys might have done it. I've seen this comment like at least 4 or 5 times and it stuck with me. So it's just like, I feel like sometimes you do your tutorial and whatnot, it looks like someone of us did it and not you did it over again. So I'm trying to make sure I kind of, you know, I'm looking out for you guys. Anyway, now that I kind of have this little bit here, right? What I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to go ahead and just, we're going to raster the layer type so we can get rid of that little drop shadow, of course, I guess you'd say effect to it. That way, of course, when you put our layer on, it looks a lot better, right? So I'm going to do, to fix this, I'm going to be using the pen tool, right? So on my corners here, I'm going to make sure I connect these corners, because what's going to happen here is it's just going to make it look 3D again, right? And let's just go ahead and do one over here as well. So things like this is a very empty, it definitely ruins the sort of like the aesthetic, or I forgot the word I'm using, but whatever, like right there is pretty good. And maybe around here, just like so. So start over here to the end, over here. Let's go up and let's just make this just like so, right? That's pretty good. And then right here, let's just connect this. And like so. All right, sweet. So I'm gonna go ahead and do is I'm gonna right click, and we're gonna go ahead and just fill sub, not sub path. Let's make sure we fill the entire path that we just did. And we're just gonna select this color for now, press okay, delete the path. Now you can see, it just makes it look nice and 3D. Maybe right here, maybe we'll change the angle again, but for tutorial purposes, this is pretty okay. And right here, it looks kind of awkward as well, but for tutorial purposes, this is okay. Okay, so I'm gonna, of course, combine these two layers together because essentially the same exact thing. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna change this color to a nice purple once again. And just about right here, let's make sure it's more of a purple, not blue. That's pretty good. That's pretty okay. Pretty okay. There we go. All right. Anyway. All right. So now we have this little purple here. We're going to go ahead, double click on this, and we're going to use a layer style here. Can you tell I'm not tired, but I am like just, I like woke up and I was just like off a nap, bro. And I haven't like fully woke up yet. I apologize, but whatever. Okay, last but not least, the layer style we use is layer style 6, right? Which is basically the last one. I also make sure, once again, I did put them in order for you guys to know. You don't have to actually find them, just go in the order. And of course, if you guys don't have my pattern pack, it's probably not gonna give you the exact pattern pack that I have. It does not look bad without the patterns. You can see it's almost very subtle, but it's just that little bit more added detail, I guess you can say. So what I'm gonna say is, this inner glow right here, what's the reason for this one is because we have this nice glow on the top, right? So kind of showing this glow here shows all of our edges very, very well. But if you want to, you can make this maybe a little more closer to this purplish glow that you have here. But essentially, it does still look freaking fantastic. And what's going to happen here is the little gradient overlay as well here, it matches the, of course, gradient overlay on the top itself. So it kind of makes it look like the lighting that we're using in a collective basis. If we were to do this in like 3D, maybe like Cinema 4D or something like that, it looks at least somewhat good, right? So last but not least, right, we're going to do a couple more things, just little added effects here, is I did use a black, or not a black, I use a purple. So if you can select the purple here, just select the purple that's very, very like just far, far bottom right. So what I'm going to do here is going to add just a little bit of more shadowing right here. You can be loose, you can be very, you know, like certain about it, but I'm gonna be pretty loose about it, just like so. This is very dark in these areas here, just kind of get rid of that. Very, very dark in those areas. There we go, it looks a little bit better. And the reason why I did it, of course, like, you want it to flow a little better, but right here, I think the drop shadow itself just looks pretty cool, because I'm gonna be doing again is on another new layer, is on all of these little angles here, the way I did this little effect right here, right, this little effect there, what I basically did was I, of course, made on these little stretches right here, and I just kind of like made it go all the way up. I went all the way to the left and right because all I'm focusing on is this line right here alone. So right click, fill this path in, excuse me, not fill the path in, make a selection, press OK. We're going to be selecting a nice purple, so I'm going to use this purple right here, just a nice dark purple. And what I did was I took a soft brush and just made sure I select on this line. Just like so. Now, if it comes outside here, that's perfectly fine. What you can do is Control D to deselect, and then take this layer, just clip and mask it right to that bottom last layer, just like so. Right? So now you can see that looks pretty dang cool. I was gonna say good, but then I don't know, whatever. I'm just gonna do this a couple more times, but you essentially get what's gonna be happening here. You have to kind of fill it out and figure it out. Not figure it out, but kind of finish it off yourself, because I'm not gonna do the entire thing, but you kind of get the idea. I kind of messed that one up just a little bit. That's whatever. I'll fix it later on if I need to. But for tutorial purposes, that's pretty good. And make selection again. And just like so. So if you kind of figure and keep on doing that, I almost look like a Pokemon thing, but whatever. it looks cool regardless, right? So essentially, we're pretty much done. Last thing I would pretty much do, and I would say it's pretty essential, is I already kind of have these little lights here, but I would also add these little lights here. So what I would do is, let's just like get rid of those lights for a second. I would choose the nicest sort of darkest color. Right now you can see the most repeated darkest color is this nice purple around here and edges around here. So what I would do, I would choose a nice little sort of color that you have going on, whether it be a yellow or purple, whatever colors you're working with, choose a nice darker color of that color scheme, right? So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna select a nice little soft brush, and I'm just gonna click once or twice, maybe three times, and around, like surrounding the actual effect without putting maybe on top of it. But if you want to, you could put it right on top as well. Let's just do it right on top. And we're gonna change our blend mode from normal to linear dodge add. And as you can see, it kind of makes it look just a little bit better. And just like all around, kind of like makes everything look more magical, or more just sort of like, I guess lighting, you'd say. It just makes it look cooler. So I think that's it for today's video here today. Yeah, that was pretty freaking cool. It was pretty long because, well, I mean, it's a little bit shorter than it is, but for me, it's 33 minutes. Hopefully it's a little shorter for you for the pen tooling reasons, of course, but I wanted to explain it in full and make sure you guys understand that. I guess you can say, if I kind of just like get rid of all this for a second, group this together, that this right here, a lot of you guys do this a lot in your banner designs, in your cartoon banner designs, or whatever cool gaming designs. But right now, of course, I'm using Fortnite as an example because it's the most popular game right now in the world. But as you can see, it just looks way better when you give more attention, more time to things that do matter. The text does matter. It shouldn't just be placed there and just say whatever sometimes. Sometimes it's really cool if you can tell yourself and show yourself that you can do something like this. And it just makes everything look way, way better, way more quality, and then just kind of like makes things look cooler. I don't know how else to say it. It's almost a certainty. Once you see it, there's no way you shouldn't be able to do it, because for one, I gave you guys all the layer styles, and it's just repeating things over and just making them bigger and bigger and bigger, and the layer styles themselves is kind of doing all the work, essentially. So, you're welcome, dude. All right, so today's tutorial is basically done. Of course, don't leave you to leave a like, turn likes on the video, because it's a secret down below, and yo, homies, we're kind of slacking on likes, dude. Let's make sure we kind of get to that 200, and of course, the PSD will be available for you guys right afterwards. Also, relax, dude. Sometimes it takes me a couple days to figure out we had 200 likes. So yeah, thank you guys so very much. Don't forget to follow me on Twitter at SoHQ. Don't forget to comment down any tutorials you want me to see me do personally. Don't forget to check out my Selfie, selfie.com/SesoHQ for any pre-mades and packs as low as $5. And yeah, I think this is a good tutorial. I'm excited for this one. Hopefully you guys can, you know, boost it up a little bit, you know, likes and stuff like that. It really does help. Share if you guys want to. And we're pretty much done. And I'll see you guys next time. So I switch you out. Don't forget to keep smiling, stay positive, and stay freaking productive, guys. I'm gonna be up for the next 5 hours because like I said, I took a nap. Too late. Dude, it was a 5 hour nap, dude. What did I do? All right, talk to you guys later. So I switch you out. Peace. It's also 11:30. Great.